Dear Dave, very nice, Dave. I truly feel for all the people that fell for this one. I cannot call them idiots due to the fact that I fell for the Donman plug back in 1991.
That's so stupid.
The Donman plug, which was a device that you could buy, attach it to your radio, connect it to your TV, and you could see our show on TV.
Right.
Little known fact, Donman was Nimrod spelled backwards.
Right.
I love that fog hat thing. And I remember when I cut that thing up, when I edited that thing together in a production studio, I purposely put Boyer in there, suddenly taking control of the
right,
bit.
I know. Even low those many years ago.
You know, and here's the thing. I had Boyer as ground control, which was so odd because he did it in his Daisy voice. And I told Boyer, all you do is just read telemetry numbers.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Just go, you know, 2,000 feet.
Right.
All of a sudden, Boyer goes, can you give me the temperature of the nose cone?
No.
And Chainsaw, as Commander Burns, is going, what? What are you doing? I look at Boyer. I look at Chainsaw, and we're like, what is he doing?
What I think it's 342 degrees.
876.
Can you give us the temperature of the nose?
What
are you doing?
Well, that was a big concern. I listened to a lot of Shuttle Audio in the day, and...
No, you don't. I had explicit instructions. So you really don't say anything. Just give distance and height, and that's it. 3 miles. 3,000 feet. Make it easy. 2 miles, 2,000 feet. Can you give us the... Could you go back and stir the oxygen tanks for us like they did on Apollo 13?
The complicator.
The complicator.
Even back then.
Just when your bit is about to be a stunning success, the complicator comes in and dicks it up.
Could you throw a wrench into the works?
And then the other thing I purposely left in is Rich, our producer Rich at the time, claiming to see the shuttle. It's throwing out smoke like you won't believe. Uh-oh. Well, that's bad. That means it's on fire. See, there's no engine on when the space shuttle comes in. It's a glider.
And still people showed up.
Oh, I know.
There was a traffic jam.
There were lawn chairs.
The police were upset.
It was awesome. Dear Dave, so on any normal day, I'm a semi-stupid a-hole, but when I excitedly told my coworker that Obama was in San Diego this morning, she snapped, he's in London, you idiot. I instantly graduated to ever-effing moron when I realized who I heard the news from. Thank you so much, you butt.
Aw.
Dear Dave, I got as far as the NBC 739 website to watch the live helicopter shots. Duh. Someone's telling me Rick Roberts on KFMB is all pissed off that we're talking about Obama being downtown.
Why?
Well, that's not part of the court of public opinion.
Why would he give a rat's ass?
I don't know. Maybe he was trying to do his own version of the April Fool's
maybe.
Joke.
Yeah.
This just in, C-SPAN is changing from channel 42 to 44.
Gosh, what? Rick!
Make a note of it.
Do I need a special Donman plug to get it?
What's a Donman plug?
I don't know.
Well, I guess we'll just have to agree to disagree here in the court.
Yeah, yeah.
Of public opinion.
I see.
Yeah.
Do I look good in my members only jacket? I'm a pilot, you know.
I will keep that cross on the hill. Have you seen the commercials where he's talking to callers?
I will chain myself to that cross on the hill.
Good.
Talking to callers on the commercial with his headphones wrapped around the microphone. That's the level of believability that they went to.
Here's Kiernan on KGB. What's going on, Kiernan?
How you doing, big guy?
I'm doing all right. How about you?
You know, I can't complain, except I feel like an idiot.
Mm.
And I hold myself and you wholly responsible.
That sounds right.
Is this your first day feeling like an idiot?
No, of course not. Okay. I've been married for 13 years.
So you're reminded constantly.
That's a good point.
That's well put.
Yeah, hourly, even.
Hourly, wow.
Just in case you forgot, you're an idiot.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, I try that voice with her, and she tells me, she says, shut up, Dave.
Yeah.
So,
Dave, I'm so mad at myself.
What
right
happened,
now.
Kiernan?
I swore years ago never to believe a damn thing you say on April 1st.
Right.
And I didn't.
Right.
Except I forgot today was April 1st.
Right.
And
sneaks
I'm
up
driving
on
the military base. I had to do some work on 32nd Street.
Yeah.
And there's some new security procedure. In case you don't know, you got to go through all kinds of BS. Sorry if you can't say that. And I'm sitting in the line, and I said, hey, is this heightened security because Obama's in town?
Right.
And the guy looks at me and goes, he's in Europe. And this is the military, mind you.
Right.
And so, and I said, no, dude, I'm listening to him on the radio.
Right.
And he goes, he's at the G20.
Yeah.
And I said, well, I don't know what you're talking about.
Right,
but
crazy man.
The guy's in, he just left Coronado.
Damn right, right. I just heard it.
And my escort, because you have to be escorted on base.
Uh-huh.
My escort looks at me and says, what are you talking about, man? I just left Coronado. And I said, well, I don't know. Maybe he's gone back way or something. And he's looking at me going, he's in Europe. And I'm like, no, guys. Look. I turned up the radio. Uh-huh. Look, listen. And they're looking at me, and the guy goes, what are you listening to?
Uh-oh.
And I said,
oh, no.
Dave Shelley and Chainsaw. And he goes, what's the date? And I was like, God. These guys are carrying guns.
Uh-huh.
They're all in uniform, and I'm arguing with them.
Yeah.
And you're a defense contractor, huh?
Yeah.
Sweet. We're in good hands.
Kiernan.
You gotta love it.
Kiernan, it's the fun of the holiday. It's more fun when you get fooled by it, just
it
like
is.
Another listener said. And for all the people who emailed me, you're an idiot.
Uh-huh.
You know, you're slipping. The president is in London. Every moron knows it. Don't send that mail to me.
Yeah.
Send it to Kiernan at Kiernan.com. See, that was the point.
You don't know how almost close you are to that email address. So thanks for that, Dave.
All right.
Be sure to up my junk filter.
Enjoy your day, Kiernan.
Bye, you too.
See you, buddy.
Bye.
You're an idiot. He's in London. Oh, really? I didn't know.
It's not been on the news or anything.
Shucks, what bad timing for my April Fool's joke. Stupid. You're slipping. You're losing.
And so half those people checked first to make sure before they scolded you.
Maggie?
Yes, hello.
What's going on, Maggie?
Yeah. Fooled me once, can't fool me again. Fool me once.
Yeah.
There's an old saying.
So I'm taking my 14-year-old son Dakota to school and listening to your show, and a huge, huge Obama fan. So we get so excited. We go in our Starbucks in Poway, and there is a line out the door. There's like 40 people in there, and they're crazy busy. So I get on my cell phone, I'm calling my mom, and I say, Obama's in town. We got to get up there and go downtown and go see him. And all the people in line start turning around and looking at me and whispering to, did you hear her? Obama's in town, and getting on their phones, and the people in their front, the people that are doing the drinks start talking, Obama's there? Oh, my gosh. So everyone looks at me, so I'm like, yeah, you know, I kind of tell everyone, Obama's here, and I think we should all go up there and see him. And everyone's like, oh, so half the people in the Starbucks dispersed on their cell phones planning to go up there and see him.
Cool.
And you guys just, oh, man, you got me so good. So I get in the car, and I turn your show on, and then I heard you the song playing in the background, and a slow realization dawned over me.
Oh, no.
Wait a minute.
Oh, no. You can never go to that Starbucks again.
Okay, my plan is I'm going to go back in there and be like, ha, ha,
I like that. I like that, Maggie.
I'm going to take full credit for your
I like
your
that.
Joke.
Plus, you made everyone leave. You got to get up in front of the line faster.
There you go.
That's genius.
There you go.
You know what? I think I'll do that every time I go to Starbucks and there's 50 people on.
Right.
Hey, there goes Obama. Everyone will take off. A small coffee, please.
So, I love you guys. I love your show. You make us laugh every morning. Well,
thanks,
so,
Maggie.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's funny. Steve.
And Jake, what's going on?
What's happening, Dave?
Just talking to you, my friend.
Oh, man. You know, I was so proud of myself. I was saying I'm not going to fall for any jokes today. And then I hear you guys on the radio this morning. And just before I was getting out to go to a meeting, I hear you talking about Obama downtown. And then I called my fiance. She works downtown. I'm like, hey, how close are you to here? She's like, a block. And I'm like, well, Obama's supposed to be downtown today. And she's like, great, because she used to live in D.C. When the president would move around, it was always a mess.
Mm-hmm.
So she's getting all over me, and I'm like, I don't know, I just heard it on the radio. And she's like, all right, well, thanks for the heads up. And then I'm sitting in my office in a meeting, and I tell my boss, hey, I guess Obama's downtown. And he goes, he's supposed to be at the summit. And then it hit me. Dave, you son of a bitch.
There's an old saying in Tennessee, I know it's right. In Texas, probably in Tennessee, that says, fool me
and
once.
In California.
Shame on...
Who?
Shame on you.
Right. Shame on you, Dave.
If fool me, we can't get fooled again.
I never knew the charm of spring. Never met it face to face.
Let's check your calendars, people. That's all you gotta do.
I never knew my heart.
That's gonna happen. Our ratings are gonna go to zero on April 1st of every day.
Totally.
I can't listen to that guy on April 1st. Can't listen to that guy on April Fool's Day.
April in Paris.
The crowd is all over you today. They're loving you.
People appreciate production values.
That's true.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Frank. Happy April.